Hi guys, and welcome to this week's Devlog. Obviously in the last week I planned the game, so this week it's time to start actually working on it. I'm going to spend the whole week trying to make it presentable so we have something that I can actually show people and kids can maybe try it and play it and see if it's interesting. But we're also going to have a normal life as always. I'm going to be going to work and I'm going to be spending some time with kids. We're going to start on Saturday with a little boy's birthday party, so you can enjoy now. See him open the presents.
Dragon.
Wait. And as you can see, he absolutely loved it. So did his mom, apparently. Hi guys, it's Monday morning. I already had a busy day to start. Dropped the kids to school, got tested for COVID because we got tested every week. Now I'm going to do some shopping and then we're going to start doing some programming work. So hopefully you can do quite a few productive things today. Okay guys, I have done some learning and stuff. I also work on the game for a little bit. So we have a basic test level. Let me show you. Just a basic level like this. And we have a player and gravity applies to it. If I press enter, the player moves sideways slowly and eventually will fall and die eventually. At the moment it doesn't die yet until it falls off the screen. I also implemented jumping, so I can do a big jump. Eventually I will tweak stats in here, so don't worry about the actual heights. I'm just doing it for the purpose of showing you how it works. Or I can do a baby jump. That happens if I just tap the space button. I can kind of release it after a while as well and it still works. So the way it works in the script quickly, it's not very difficult. If I release the button and the player velocity Y is lower than the minimum jumping velocity, it will just automatically become minimum jumping velocity. So jumping velocity is 400 here, 100 here. Let me just set bigger number for you on jumping so you can see it. And as you can see, jumping velocity here. So if I release the bottom early, that's what happens. If I hold it for too long and not release it here, it already goes flying all the way. Okay, that's all I have at the moment. Not much, but it's slowly getting there. So I did some more work and employ my best testers.
Gate, and we can get it. He's telling me! Wood! See?
Now what do we do?
We're done!
So we've got into the garden! We haven't had a picnic!
Wait.
And this is what happened. They decided to play Untitled Goose Game. Clearly, more work is needed. Hi guys, it's Friday evening and I finished working on my game for this week. Let me show you how far we are. To warn you, it's early alpha footage and it is not pretty yet. So it's not final graphics for sure. Okay, let's go. So that's what we have. I have built the initial character. That's going to be the character size mostly, and that's going to be about size of a tile set. Let me just make it bigger so you can see better. Okay, so what we can do so far. We can jump up and down. I have ability to do like a half jump. So if I just tap it, I can just go one little jump, or I can do the little bigger jump over here. Okay. When I activate the character, it moves. I can jump over a single block, I can jump over two, but I cannot jump over three. What I'm doing in here at the moment, making the game in 4K, so I can then scale it up. So if somebody has a weird resolution with the longer screen, in here you see the tiles are not distorted, you just happen to see more of the screen. So it shouldn't be a major issue for a side scroll runner. Might give you slightly more advantage on a longer screen, but it's not a competitive game anyway. What I'm particularly proud of in here is this. That's my debug screen, so you can see in here player and exit are valid. Exit is placed in my test scene in here as the exit node. So as soon as I get to the exit node, I know that I passed it. So let me show you quickly when we go. Jump over that, jump over here. His player passed exit is true. And when that is true, we're going to eventually end the game and skip to the next level. So I will be able to place multiple exits on every new level I have, and that's going to be quite simple. Have it on done through the auto load. So that works perfect for me. What I also like in here is like I can see my frames per second, I can see my static memory use, I can see if player is jumping or not, so I can jump now. If I jump again, I cannot jump. So it doesn't matter how much I press, I cannot jump in the air. I can check multiple things. If I want to check anything else, I can use my scripts. I have a debug overlay script in here. Debug manager, I just pass new signals and I can see whatever I want. So say I would like to pass some, check what is the gravity of the player at any given time, I can quickly do that. That will pass the new stat. I can see now that player gravity at this point in time is 2304. It's going to remain constant for me. Gravity is calculated for a player, as I explained in the earlier video, I think, in the process, so I can calculate how far I want to jump and then it calculates gravity for me from that. My debug overlay and all my utility scripts are available on GitHub, and the link will be in the description for you to get them, guys. Okay, that's it for this week. Thank you everybody for watching. I will be working on the game next week. I will try to build some more levels, see if I can tweak jumping to look better. And hopefully that will do it. Take care.